Yes, that's right. Another third-party company has come and gone. That being Suntoys, which had only made these two molds, so far. And while there were only two versions made, they did come out with different recolors. They had the red and black one here, of RX-72, the normal colors, and then one with clear armor, much like what Bandai would do. They have done a clear armor of their Master Raid RX-72. And then the Ava also had the kind of the angel version, which had the halo and the clear arm, which they've also done that with Bandai kits, so it makes sense. And that's it. No more. They're done. Now, it's not like what happened with Dragon Ball Mocha. It's not as serious, because they basically gave up. Suntoys, it's hard to say. There's not a clear, definitive response, so it could have been Bandai, but I doubt it. From what I've heard, basically, it was... Who would have thought it was really hard to make models that are SD-scaled with internal frames at a cheap price? Well, duh. I mean, I could have told them that. What I would have liked them to have done is to just give us this kind of proportion, but just make it a high-grade kind of model. You don't need an internal frame. It was cool to have, like, a master-grade kind of SD with the all the internal skeleton and the working pistons and everything, but it's too small. And for your first... For this to be the first kit they came out with, that was very... They had... Their hopes are... Their bar was too high for being the first release. Ava was more simple. It's, they both have issues. I think I mentioned them in the actual reviews. They're not, like, amazing. They're good for what they are. But they have problems. The Ava not so much because it's not as much of an inner frame as this. It does have some inner detail, but nothing compared to the RX-72. So it's better, I feel. But it still has loose joints here and there, and it's hard for it to, stand. They did give you a stand. And they also wanted to give you a battery with light-up head. So they had to make the space for that. Make sure that that function, which I couldn't get mine to work for the Ava. It just... way too much. Way too soon. They should have done... If they had done what Bandai is doing, that maybe... I'd like to think that they saw stuff like this, and Bandai decided to do their new cross silhouette with inner frames, but simple, cross-compatible inner frames they can reuse over and over again. So that's what Suntoy should have done, made a very basic inner frame that they can reuse over and over again with different armor, because unfortunately, I can't show you the pictures. The website I found this information, I couldn't save the pictures. I don't know why. But they were in the process of making a unit zero. They had the shield made, they were remolding the head, they had a prototype, it looks like, of the 02. They had 3D renderings of an SD Strike Gundam. And they were starting to do a 3D rendering of the GP-02 Pisalis. Even an SD Sinaju. But I can't show them, unfortunately, because I couldn't get the pictures. But they were in the works. So, it's sad that they're gone, because I do like these. They could have, like... It was a good starting point. They could have gotten better and better if they kept going, but they went too extravagant right off the bat. It was not a good idea. But I do appreciate what they tried to do. So, it's unfortunate, but maybe somebody else will come along with just a simple SD so we can get a whole bunch of different... Like, here's an update to the cross silhouette. Another picture came up, and they're actually doing an SD Ifrit, an SD Zeta, an SD Freedom, an SD Zaku, and I think that's all the ones so far. So the line is going to be pretty awesome with kits we never had SDs of. I'm very like, I don't think we ever had an Ifrit. Pretty sure. And the Freedom, we had one, which is still good, but this was really good. Zeta, we had one. Didn't even have that in the RE line. Not the RE line, the, next edge, the EX standard. So, yeah, I mean, I guess, maybe, like, it's kind of like what they had here, but easier to do. So, well, that's another one gone, but it was an interesting ride. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.